Okay, hope you guys are ready for chapter 3, endodontics. So as you know, this chapter is a this part of the exam is going to be a little different than the previous years. We are working on plastic teeth, which you can purchase upstairs on the 5th floor. So we'll be going over that entire section with you. Starting off pretty much with endo is the only part of the exam that is pre-scheduled for you. That means you should go on the REBS website now, log in, and see what time is scheduled for you. It's a 3-hour session that you cannot miss and you cannot switch, so you're required to go at that time. You're also allocated 30 minutes before the start time to set up, so you're really given 3.5 hours total to do the exam. For the endo section, it has two parts, which are both completed in that 3-hour window. The first one is to access, instrument, and obturate a plastic maxillary central incisor, and the second part is just to access a plastic mandibular first molar. When they say access for the plastic mandibular first molar, they mean you just need to unroof it enough that you can see visually all the canal orifices. Supplies. So when you walk in, you should already bring with you everything that you may need. That is your MagiPro upper and lower arches with all sextants and sides. And those sextants cannot have the any teeth in them other than those that are part of the typodonts. So that means no old teeth, nothing like that. No heavy body, nothing. They have to be clean MagiPros the way they were originally purchased. I don't believe we need an articulator at our site, so no extracted teeth, and you can see online if anything changes. The grading examiners will give you a Ziploc bag, and inside you'll see a new sextant that already has teeth mounted for you. So you should receive two new sextants, which have a barcode on them. And they will come with two radiographic views, one buccal lingual, one mesiodistal for each of the two teeth. And you will get an endo worksheet to fill out. You can see the endo worksheet inside of your candidate guide. So these are what the two MagiPros look like. This is exactly how you should bring them to the exam. No teeth in them other than these. How will the exam work? Again, make sure to go online and see what time your exam is. You can come 30 minutes before, bring all your supplies, and have your candidate badge on. You cannot bring no cell phones, no smartwatches, nothing of that sort. You'll walk in and a proctor will give you a green card which will tell you which station is yours. Once you're there, you can set up your articulator once you get the sextants from the Ziploc bag. But do not start drilling or doing anything. Don't even put on a rubber dam. The only thing you're allowed to do is lay out your supplies and put your MagiPro into the articulator and turn on the light. In regards to radiographs, for the exam, we'll be using the same things that we always use in the sim lab. So you can go play with them now. And it's very important that you put all your sharps in the sharps container. You actually can fail the exam if they see you throwing sharps in the regular garbage. Once you receive your sextant, on the back of it with a Sharpie, write your REBS candidate number. So it's a letter and then two or three numbers after that, which you'll know for sure by then. So put down the lingual of each sextant in permanent marker, but do not cover up the pre-printed barcode. So once again, within those 30 minutes, you're allowed to set up, put your articulator together, put it in the mannequin, but do not drill or you will fail the exam. Start check. So there is a start check, which is when you can officially begin. The start check is the official time the exam will start, which is 30 minutes after the setup time. At that time, your endo arches should be mounted, your candidate number on the lingual of each sextant, your mannequin is in the correct position, and word of caution, if your mannequin is in a position that is not allowed, meaning a way that a patient can't be, you will fail the exam. And the light should be on with a mirror on the tray, and you should have your endo worksheet completed. No rubber dam at this time, okay? So you will also get a start check for both teeth at the same time. If you drill any time before, you will fail, so no handpieces. Rubber dam. So for the rubber dam, as I said before, you do not need it, and you really should not have it at the time of the start check. But once the start check happens, you're allowed to place the rubber dam on, and it should stimulate a proper placement on a patient. It's required during all times of the exam, except for when you're taking radiographs. Okay, so while you're taking radiographs, you are allowed to take off the rubber dam. If you do any procedure without a rubber dam and a floor examiner notices, you will auto-fail the exam and not be allowed to retake it in this weekend. In regards to placement of the rubber dam, you can do single or multiple tooth isolation, and they actually recommend multiple tooth. The reason being is because the little tooth they give us is plastic, and if you put a clamp on it, it might fracture the tooth. And you don't get a new tooth, so you don't really want to risk that. Put the clamp on the tooth next to it and do a several teeth rubber dam. If the tooth at any times get loose, you must notify the floor examiner immediately, same thing, or you will fail. So what are the common things you can fail for? Pretty much table topping, bringing any notes other than the candidate guide itself, using any magnification other than your loops, helping other candidates, which includes talking to them, helping them set up mannequins, critiquing their work in any way, helping them with radiographs, anything of that that is noticed will cause you to immediately fail the exam and be excused. And you're not allowed to have an assistant. So, as we said before, there are two parts to this exam. The first part is the anterior tooth, which is essential, maxillary incisor. You're going to access instrument and obturate. You can do the procedure however you like. So you can follow whatever techniques you like. You're really allowed to use lateral condensation, warm vertical, whatever you feel is necessary and easiest to you. If at any time a root fractures, you can still pass the exam with up to a 3 if you meet all the remaining criteria. So you don't auto-fail the exam even if a root fractures. Again, you can obturate with any technique you like as long as there's no gutta percha coronal to the CEJ. You can also leave notes to the grading examiners if there's anything suspicious or something that you would like to write down for them. You can remove the actual sextant from the typodont to take your x-rays. And very important, with regards to grading, you're only submitting the pre-op x-rays, which were taken for you, and the post-op x-rays. That's it. So they're not going to see your working length master files, nothing. They're only going to see pre-op with 2 views, buccal lingual mesial distal, and post-op with 2 views, buccal lingual and mesial distal. That's it. Posterior tooth, you're only accessing. So you access the tooth, find the 3 canal orifices. They all should be identifiable visibly, but do not instrument, don't put a file in there, don't do anything like that. And you will also take 2 radiographic images for your post-op for this tooth. Although it's only an access, you are taking radiographs for this tooth as well. So, just the rules for taking radiographs. You should remove the sextant when taking radiographs. The machines are the same as we've used for endoblock. You can use soft wax to hold up the sextant if you like, but they prefer for you to use the blue stand. The blue stand came with your MagiPro, so you should have it. If you've lost it, ask a friend, maybe you can borrow it, but don't ask them during the exam. The plastic is not dense, so you might have to adjust the exposure, which you can play around with now in the sim lab. You do not need a rubber dam or clamp for the post-op photographs, which are the only photographs you're submitting. The post-op photographs should be in the same format as the pre-op, which is a buccal view and a proximal view. When you take the images, you also see a little sphere at the corner. It should be visible at all times. That's just to prove that you're using the sextant that was given to you. When you're posting your radiographs, you should write your candidate number, tooth number, and the anterior-posterior. So just like the example here. And you are responsible for providing high-quality radiographs or you will be penalized. We'll go over how much the penalties are for everything in a bit. So completion. When you're all done with the exam, you want to give back the Ziploc bag with your 2 sextants, which have your candidate number on the lingual, your completed endo worksheet, your pre-op photographs, and your post-op radiographs. If you leave the lab without all items submitted, you will fail, okay? And you can't go back and forth. So once you leave, that's it. So be sure you gave them everything that is listed for you on that endo worksheet. So some definitions that are important for understanding how they grade. Apical perforation, as you know, that's when you make a new apical foramen. Ledging is when there's an irregularity in the canal wall filling. Strip perforation means you made a lateral side on the root. Transporting means you changing position of the canal by straightening the wall. Unroofing is when the dentin that covers the chamber is still there with no visible ledges or overhangs. And zipping is transporting the apical foramen. So scoring. This section is the same as everywhere else. You need a 3 or higher to pass. The three is made up of three different parts. 27% for your anterior axis, 27% for posterior axis, and 46% for your anterior obturation. If you fail, so if the average when they put these all together is less than a three, you can retake the endosection on day three. So what are common deductions? You can lose up to 0.2 per tooth for undiagnostic post-op radiographs and 0.3 per tooth for missing post-operative radiographs overall. Okay, so don't forget to take your post-op radiographs. If they have to take it for you afterwards, you're going to lose points. Late penalties, 1 to 5 minutes, you'll lose 0.2, 6 to 10, you'll lose 0.4, 11 to 15, 0.6, more than 16 minutes, you fail. Auto failure, access the wrong tooth, access started before a start check or start check given, the pulp chamber is entered before start check or start given, you fail to use universal precautions, so that kind of the rubber dam stuff and the sharps, or violation of any simulation protocol, so table topping and such. Going back just real quick, be sure to recognize that when you're given a start check, you still have to wait for the examiners to say start to everyone. So there is a 3-hour clock window that you're working within. Just because you got everything you in your 30 minutes of setup time, and if you set up in 15 minutes, you still cannot start. You can't start until everyone is given a start time. And that is it. Good luck.